Today we will talk about the one and only Big O. The Big O notation is incredibly helpful to describe how an algorithm scales. But in the way it is thrown around often, it is completely useless and misleading. And if you think this looks fine, you need to keep watching, because we as scientists have fucked up and I need to fix this now. You know, I studied computer science for a single reason: to tell people they are wrong with confidence. And they are wrong in so many ways. So prepare for the nerdiest of nerdy rants. In Big O notation, the O stands for Ordnung or order.
German.
It describes how an algorithm scales towards the size of its inputs, either in memory space or in computation time. If someone talks about an n squared algorithm, they usually mean the algorithm's execution time is O of n squared. And one would assume the execution time scales something like this. But we don't know that. That is not what it says. It could very well scale like this, this, or like this. Does this sound like this notation is completely useless for the practical purpose people use it for?
Yes.
Yes, it does. And let me explain why this happens. The first problem is, it is just an upper bound. It only says this thing does not scale worse than that thing. And I can give you a valid Big O estimation for everything you will ever come across. It's very likely to be Big O of n to the power of n to the power of n. It's probably much better, but who knows? But when I say this algorithm runs in O of n squared, you would not expect it to also run in O of n. So what you want to use is Big O's sister, Big Theta, because everyone loves Big Theta.
However, there is a much larger problem that is a bit weirder. The problem is, you and me, we live in a finite world. There are finite things, we solve finite problems. So the problems our algorithms solve are also finite, which means the runtime estimates we need are for finite problems. Which means Big O, or Theta for that matter, do not say anything. It's just not what it is made for, because Big O is defined for infinitely large problems. You know, those that never occurred, except hypothetically in the mind of a theoretical computer scientist. What Big O actually means by definition is the following. F of x is how the algorithm actually scales. G of x is our Big O notation. We send both of them to infinity and see who wins the race. If f of x is far faster, we land at infinity. If g of x is far faster, we land at zero. Imagine if g of x is 2 times f of x, we land at a number. And as long as it is not infinity, we say f is in O of g. This means x squared is in O of x squared. But also 2 times x squared is in O of x squared. And also this is in O of x squared. Because for an infinitely large problem, only the highest potency matters. So for us filthy, finite mortal beings, Big O does not say this should be faster than that. It basically says nothing at all. So why do so many people get this wrong?
We tricked them.
We tricked them with the notation because theoretical computer scientists don't care about anyone except other theoretical computer scientists. They don't mean to, they just forgot there are other people. Okay, so this equal sign here is the offender. It makes no sense. It looks so harmless, but you have learned that when A equals B, B also equals A. But for Big O notation, it does not. An example for you. X equals O of x. And because it is an upper bound, of course, equals O of x squared. But when we flip it around like we are used to with equals, O of x squared equals O of x. Wait, that's just wrong. Using equals for something that is not symmetrical should be illegal. What we actually mean to say is that x is in O of x, because O of x is the set of functions that scale at most as fast as x. So we should write this, because when the pencil is in the box is not also in the pencil.
Now what do we do with all of that? Take Big O with a grain of salt, because it really does not say a lot. It is good to think about how your algorithm scales, but think about how it scales on your actual problem size. And don't just omit every factor, because it does not matter for infinitely large problems. This also means thinking about your problem size, because your problem is likely not infinitely large. And that is a good thing. In many cases, an algorithm in O of n squared can be much faster than one in O of n log n. For example, when you need to sort 100 elements. It does not matter how fast you could sort infinitely many elements. And all those small little constants Big O just drops, they are often the most important ones. Like a write to a hard drive. It just takes a long time. So guys, it's so rare for us to talk about stuff that we actually studied. If you like that, let us and YouTube know and push that like button. Also, if there are other computer science topics you would like to see us cover, write it in the comments.